Hello, it's Sarah, and tonight I have a haul video, and I have a couple, I have something I want to share, but you know what, I'm going to start the haul because I think I got a lot of stuff. It's Hobby Lobby, and I have a few projects in mind that I wanted to get a few things for. I don't go to Hobby Lobby very often, and so when I do, I get quite a bit, so that's why I have quite a bit here. This stuff, mostly everything I got was 50% off. Metal Gallery, the Paper Studio, and spare parts, all of that was 50% off, so I did pretty good. So here's, let's just get started. I got some glass beads. I love these orange ones. These are glass, and they're 50% off, so you can't go wrong, but these are just like flowery, and the orange ones because Halloween's coming up. I was thinking about Halloween. These are just spacers that I really like. They're flowers and they're kind of thick. I really like those. I got them in the two colors. And then these spacers. These are, not spacers, bead caps. So these were under $1 for these, but they're real little. So I don't have a lot of little bead caps, so I wanted to get those. These little gems, flatback gem flowers were 50% off, and I don't have, these colors were kind of different. This is like a purpley blue and this red, so I knew I didn't have any colors like that. I got two stamps. I really wanted some word stamps, and I was disappointed because they didn't have, like, I've seen the definition of artist, like different things like that. I was hoping they'd have a bit more, but I did find this Halloween one, and it's actually it was $7.99. It's a Stampabilities stamp, which is their I'm pretty sure it's their brand, and this was 50% off, but it was $8, so it was still $4. But I have been wanting some more Halloween words. I have some Halloween projects I'm thinking about, and this was only $1. And it's family rules, mind your manners, play nice, share, show gratitude, but it's another Stampability, so it was 50% off, so that's always great, love that. Let's get into all the spare parts. I got quite a bit, because these, I feel like, if for those of you who don't know, Spare Parts does a lot of Tim Holtz things, like they kind of make their own version of his ideology pieces. So like these, look at this, these little feet, I mean, they're basically the Tim Holtz feet, I mean, in their spare parts. So these were only $3. I think I got two packs of them. I got two packs of those because I have a project I'm gonna do this block, which is the biggest of the blocks that I did for my Halloween art doll. And I'm gonna put the feet on that. I got the Tim Holtz ones of the actual ideology of the box corners. So I'm gonna put some corners on this. So there's 8 of them in here, 3, 6, 7, 8, which I really liked because I'm gonna do 2. Because I haven't decided if I'm gonna cover it with paper and then embellish it, or if I want to do collage background like I did on the Halloween piece, because he has so many cool stamps and all that, and it's, you know, it's, it would be, I could do, maybe I'll make 2, because I have enough. I got 2 sets of feet, I got 2 box corners, so that was one of the projects I specifically had in mind. These are just some metal filigree flowers. This was $2 for these. And these are nice size, so I really like them. And then look at these gears. These were only $1.50 for these gears. And these are very different from his gears, or even the bead, what's it called? Bead something that Michael sells. So I got a pack of them. I needed spinners. I didn't have any spinners. And you can put these in the middle of clocks or anything really, just by themselves with a brad. So I got 2 packs of those. Those were $2 a piece. And these are like clock charms, I guess, or just little different timepieces, all different timepieces, which I really liked. I like the quality of their charms. And then these, because I have a total, ever since I got my tag, which is right here from Jill, the sand has, I've been interested in the sand, so I went to the Tim Holtz blog, or well, his website actually, and the recipe for this sand is on there. So I wanted to get some of the ingredients for that because I want to do a canvas. I haven't done this Prima Doll stamp. Kirby's barking. The mermaid Prima Doll stamp. So I'm totally, I want to do that, and I'm totally inspired by this tag, and I didn't get it, and I probably should have the his die for the I might get it. I still might get it, but I was thinking I would just fussy cut out some stuff or something. I don't know. I was going to look through some of my paper and see what I have, but these dies are super cool. And actually, Jill said this is a cuddle bug die, or she said it was some other type of die, not his. So anyway, I have some things in mind, and I just thought these charms, they're so well made. They look so nice, and I love the color. I love the crab. Like, I could stick the crab in the sand, so I got that. I got his, this is glitter, distress glitter, and it's in the color of, vintage photo. Oh, no, this is antique linen, but this was one of the ingredients for the sand, because, I mean, if you look at it, you can see how glittery it is and sparkly. So I got that. I wasn't able to get the embossing powder, which I don't think I really, I think I'll be able to do it without it. And if not, I'll use whatever. Because, I mean, he really just mixes it with glossy accents. I mean, you don't heat it up or anything. Oh, I got some more spare parts. Hold on. Let me bring these. Oh, wait. While we're talking about the mermaid, I was so inspired, too, by this pennant I got for my pennant challenge. I know you guys remember this. And, I mean, she definitely had to have reduced this, because look how big. This is the actual stamp. And look how big this is compared to that. So she reduced it and made this beautiful pennant. This is by, her name is Cindy Harrington, and she's living the scrappy life on YouTube. And I just adore this mermaid. So I bought these sequins. And I'm going to do my best to imitate what she's done here with these sequins and see how I make out. So I got some bigger ones because my mermaid's a bit bigger, and some smaller ones, which are only, you know, they're $1.99, so that's not bad. And what else? I love these little flowers. These are adorable. These were half price, so $2.50. But these burlap flowers, I just love the quality of these. And they're not too big, and they have a little wooden center. And then these, I think, are more of a linen. But they're little tiny, like, I love these, I don't know, forget-me-not style four-petal flowers with a little wooden bead. And then these little ones, I thought I could throw some of these in as well to play with this color. But these are tiny, and these, again, have like a little wooden bead at the center. They're super cute. Micro flowers. I love them. And they're 50% off. So I had to grab them. So yeah, I had some projects in mind when I went. So it was definitely worth it. You know, oh, I got some We Are Memory Keepers. What are these called? Eyelets. I needed some. I needed to replenish my eyelets. I got some new stuff from Tim Holtz. These are the heart charms, which really look cool because these look, this has hope, dream, us. You know, there's little words in there, so they're super cute. I can't wait to use them. I got this stencil, the Tim Holtz. This is called Harlequin. I was struggling a bit. Well, I haven't been able to find like stencils. I mean, it's $5.99. That's not a bad price, actually. I've gotten a couple of the Heidi Swap ones. I'm trying to find, oh, I got this, the Chevron, which I think if you're spraying, it's probably a lot better. But when I was painting over it and stuff, and it's just a little flimsy. I mean, it's not bad. It's probably all right, but I don't know. I like this for like a pointy, like I love this better. So, and this is one that Mary Jane had used in her video, and I don't know, I just liked it, and they had it, and so I grabbed that real quick. And finally, well, actually, not finally, these two are my last things. Oh, no, wait, I got this. This is hemp. No, jute. Jute cord. This was only $1.50, but I thought I could do something with this on my mermaid thing too. So I mean, a lot of natural fibers, the sand, the shells. I might just buy real shells. Like, I like the look of real shells. I don't know about a seahorse, if I can find a seahorse. But anyway, so I got the stencil, and then these are his label letters. I really like these. These are only $1.99, and Jill had used these on one of the envelopes that she put some of my goodies in when we did our swap. So I saw those and thought they're cool, because you can just put love, hope, dream. You can spell out whatever you want. And then this is his clear, I don't know what it's called, just sayings it's called. It has real, I love just hello friend, enjoy the journey. I mean, there's just basic make a wish, good luck, thank you, get well soon. So real common sentiments, and a nice little place to put them. So I did get that. Now, none of that was on sale. None of the Tim Holtz stuff was on sale. And then real quick too, coming up, I'm going to be doing a tutorial, I believe, because I was so inspired by this little book that Jill sent me with our swap. I really like the idea of keeping your ATCs, or just special ATCs maybe, or even to send someone some ATCs. So I'm kind of trying to come up with a similar way. There, I haven't been able to find the tutorial for this, so kind of blending a couple videos I've seen and trying it myself, and I've come up with, I kind of made this, which was made with coin envelopes, and it works. It's pretty good. It holds them. I mean, it's just made with cardstock, because I was just kind of, it was my prototype, and I wanted to see how it worked. And then I did do another one. This one is because I wanted to put Halloween. Where did I put those Halloween? Here they are. These are a little bit dimensional. They're not a ton. I mean, you can see a little bit of dimension if you, you know, I mean, they're not totally flat. I've popped up a few things, but I wanted to put some Halloween ATCs in here. And I was just playing with some Tim Holtz. What is this called? I think it's called ombre. No, not ombre. The bandana technique or something. I forget. But these are all flat, and they fit in there pretty good. I made these pockets too, because I ran out of coin envelopes, and actually Hobby Lobby didn't have any today. I closed it with Velcro, but when you put the dimensional ones in here, it gets bigger. So I need to make this gusset a bit bigger. So it definitely has to be like this. So I'm gonna kind of, I wanted to go for this look, right? So it fans out, but I think it's better if the bottom is just as wide, because then dimensional ones be able to see. But I mean, this is not useless. It's still perfectly good for flat ATCs, but I'm gonna keep working on it, and I will be back with a tutorial when I figure it out, because I just think that's a super cute idea. Like I said, I mean, even if you have just some favorite Halloween ones and you wanna do, you know, a Halloween one, a Christmas one, you could do themed ones, you know, Tim Holtz ones, make a Tim Holtz holder for them. I think the bigger the, what would you call that? Like the accordion or the gusset, you know, you'll be able, like this one has 7 spots in it. So, I mean, you could probably make it as big as you wanted. It's like a little file folder cabinet thing. All right. But anyway, so that's what I got for you today. I hope you like that, and thanks for watching.